بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله سابغ النعم ودافع النقم، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، الهادي إلى السداد وإلى سبيل الرشاد. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله النبي الأمي الطاهر الزكي، صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وذريته وعلى كل تقي نقي خفي. Amma ba'd, my dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. No doubt that we live in exceptional times and under extraordinary emergency conditions as a result of the sudden emergence of the new coronavirus that causes the COVID-19 disease, which infected more than 1,800,000 people and caused the death of more than 110,000 persons around the world so far. And the numbers are unfortunately increasing exponentially. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for safety and wellness for all. The emergence of this virus has sparked controversy among Muslims, ordinary and scholars, on matters related to the topic of trust in Allah, tawakkul, temporary suspension in mosques for Friday and congregational prayers, and how to deal with the ritual washing, funeral prayer, and burial of deceased Muslims, and whether this pandemic is Allah's punishment, mercy, or test. Therefore, I saw that it is appropriate at this time to talk about these religious aspects related to this pandemic. And I begin today, Allah willing, to talk about the first of these aspects that some of us have misunderstood, namely the aspect of trust in Allah, or what we call at-tawakkul. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may he be exalted, commanded us to put our trust in him. And the first to be commanded by that was his beloved messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah said to him, trust in Allah, and sufficient is Allah as a guardian. Wa tawakkal ala Allah, wa kafa billahi wakila. And he also said, وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى الْعَزِيزِ الرَّحِيمِ, and rely upon the Almighty, the Most Merciful. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said, and rely upon Allah, for verily Allah loves those who depend upon him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَوَكِّلِينَ. And he said also, and rely upon Allah, if you are truly believers. وَتَوَكَّلُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. And rely upon Allah, for verily you are on the clear truth. وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّكَ عَلَى الْحَقِّ الْمُبِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. Whoever trusts in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah would be sufficient for him or her as a guardian. And trust in Allah, my dear brothers and sisters, is one of the attributes of the believers. The Almighty said, the believers are only those who, when Allah is mentioned, their hearts become fearful. And when his verses are recited to them, it increases them in faith. And upon their Lord, they rely. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this ayah, إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. And trust in Allah, my dear brothers and sisters, entails having strong faith in the heart that only Allah is capable of benefiting and or harming, and that nothing happens in the world without his knowledge and permission. Allah said in the context of his talk about magic. فيتعلمون منهما ما يفرقون به بين المرء وزوجه وليس بضارهم شيئا إلا بإذن الله وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون. And the translation for that is that so that they learn from them, from the angels, Harut and Marut, that by they learn from them that by which they cause separation between a person and his wife. But they won't harm anyone through it except with Allah's permission. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said in the context of his talk about najwa or private conversation or whispering, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا النَّجْوَى مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ لِيَحْزُنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَيْسَ بِضَارِّهِمْ شَيْئًا إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, private conversation is only from Satan, that he may grieve those who have believed, but he won't harm them at all, except by the permission of Allah, and upon Allah let the believers rely. And upon Allah, let the believers rely. We know, my dear brothers and sisters, that harm may be afflicted through multiple causes. But it does not occur by these causes unless Allah wills it to occur or unless Allah has predestined it to happen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, say, nothing will strike us except what Allah has written for us. He is our Lord, and upon Allah the believers rely. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah, of course, he said, قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا هُوَ مَوْلَانَا وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. This is really the meaning of trust in Allah, is to think heartily that benefit or harm cannot affect anyone except by Allah's permission, even when the causes or the means or the tools that lead to them are readily available. Trust is a heartfelt worship that embodies the sincerity of dependence on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in bringing benefits and keeping away harm. Ibn Hajar, may Allah have mercy on him, defined tawakkul or trust in Allah as to be independent of means or of causes after making use of them. The meaning of reliance on Allah is not to throw ourselves to an imminent danger without taking the means for prevention and say that this danger will not harm us, and that trust in Allah with our hearts is enough and sufficient. It is not throwing ourselves in front of a speeding car and say that this will not harm us. It is not drinking poison and say it won't harm us. It is not throwing ourselves into the fire and say that the fire won't burn us. No one in their right mind, my dear brothers and sisters, would say or act upon that. Only the foolish and ignorant would believe that. For how does this understanding be correct or compatible with Allah's saying, and do not throw yourselves into destruction with your own hands, وَلَا تُلْقُوا بِأَيْدِيكُمْ إِلَى التَّهْلُكَةِ, and his saying, and do not kill yourselves or anyone or any other one, verily Allah is to you ever merciful, وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِكُمْ رَحِيمًا. So there are, my brothers and sisters, means and causes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created. Those causes or means, they lead to results. This is the cause and effect notion. For example, if a bullet hits you, it will kill you. If you touch the fire, it will naturally burn you. Unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala disallows the bullet to kill, and this allows the fire to burn, as he did disallow the fire to burn his prophet Ibrahim. He prevented the fire from burning Ibrahim alayhi salam. He commanded it to be cool and safe for him. He said, فَقُلْنَا يَا نَارُ كُونِي بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا عَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمٍ. But was Allah's prevention of the fire from burning Ibrahim something ordinary and usual? Or was it in fact a breach of habit? There is no doubt that it was a violation of the usual. It was a miracle, an exception to Allah's rule that the fire should cause burning when it touches anyone or anything. But he wanted to make an exception in the case of his Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wanted to show his glory and might. He wanted to protect his messenger alayhi salam. And if Allah wills, it will not burn. It will not burn. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to show that the fire does not cause burning by itself, but by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, who gave the fire its property of burning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the means and causes, but they themselves cannot effect or bring about benefits nor drive away harm by themselves, but by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn al-Qayyim, may Allah's mercy be upon him, he said, reliance, meaning tawakkul, trust in Allah, reliance, tawakkul, is one of the greatest causes of bringing in what is desired and keeping away what is hateful. Whoever denies the means, he continues, has something wrong with his or her understanding of the notion of tawakkul. But for this trust, my dear brothers and sisters, for tawakkul to be sound and complete, one has to be independent of the means, such that his heart's relation to those means is disconnected, so that his or her heart is attached only to Allah, and his body should be the one which should act upon the means. So taking the means while entrusting success, protection, or whatever goal you are after, is to entrust that to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, is the meaning, is the true meaning of tawakkul, is the true meaning of relying completely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tawakkul in itself is actually one of the means, and it is commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But my dear brothers and sisters, abstaining from using means and tools in seeking what is beneficial and repelling what is harmful is not of tawakkul, does not belong to tawakkul. It is rather an inability, it is rather laziness. So everything that leads to abandoning taking action and making use of means is not trust in Allah, is not tawakkul. Evidences from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the prophetic traditions indicate that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us in case of any kind of danger to take precaution, be on guard, and be careful. This is one of the means to protect ourselves from harm, which is commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, Allah said, "O you who have believed, take your precaution and either go forth in groups or companies or go forth all together." يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا خُذُوا حِذْرَكُمْ فَانْفِرُوا ثُبَاتٍ أَوْ انْفِرُوا جَمِيعًا. And he also said to his Prophet, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, "And when you are among them and lead them in prayer, let a group of them stand in prayer with you and let them carry their arms. And when they have prostrated, let them be in position behind you and have the other group come forward, which has not yet prayed, and let them pray with you, taking precaution and carrying their arms. Those who disbelieve wish that you would neglect your weapons and your baggage so they could come down upon you in one single attack. But there is no blame upon you if you are troubled by rain or are ill for putting down your arms. But take precaution, خذوا حذركم, Indeed, Allah has prepared for the disbelievers a humiliating punishment. This verse is in the Quran in the context when the Messenger of Allah, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, was with the Muslim army fighting a battle. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the instructions here to take precaution and to be on guard. So if trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means only a heartfelt trust in him without taking the necessary means, which he himself commanded us to take, then the order to take up arms, the command of one group to guard another while the other group is praying, and the repeated directive to be cautious and alert would be meaningless here. Therefore, what is intended by this verse is to make use of the means and tools of protection available. Place our trust in Allah and to firmly believe that Allah alone is the keeper and protector, not the means and the tools. This exact meaning is also indicated by the answer that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave to the man who asked him about whether to leave his ride untied and depend on Allah and keeping it safe, or tie it and trust in Allah. The Messenger said, tie it and trust in Allah. Likewise, the meaning is also emphasized in the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which he said, flee from the leper the same way you flee from the lion. Also, as well as in the hadith in which the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to the leper who came to see him and pledge allegiance, he told him, go back, we accepted your pledge. Also, Umar ibn al-Khattab, may Allah's pleasure be upon him, when he decided not to enter Amwas, the city which was afflicted by the plague, his decision was in compliance with the command of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which he said, if you hear of a plague in a land, do not enter it. And if it afflicts a land while you are in it, do not get out of it to escape from it. Furthermore, it is reported that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the infected must not visit the healthy. All of the aforementioned verses of the glorious Quran and the honorable hadiths command us to take precaution, to be on guard, and to make use of tools and means to drive away harm if it is known before its occurrence, for prevention is better than cure. In short, my dear brothers and sisters, I say that trust in Allah, or tawakkul, is to make use of means and to depend heartily on Allah, believing that causes and or means cannot bring in benefits nor drive away harm on their own, but by the will and permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My beloved brothers and sisters, this was my humble attempt to clarify the meaning of tawakkul and to explain that tawakkul does not contradict making use of means to achieve what is desired, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created those means and commanded us to use them to bring benefits and keep away harm. Inshallah, I will be speaking in the in next episodes on other religious aspects related to the COVID-19 pandemic. I ask Allah the Almighty to protect us all from this pandemic, grant us safety and wellness, and to lift it from us and from Muslims and from all people in all the world. I ask forgiveness of God, of Allah, for me and you and other Muslims, and I ask Him to guide us to that which is best. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.